everybody. We're back on another episode of Twitter Side. So this week's episode is about everyone can be a writer. This week we had one guest speaker who was really special and
really inspiring.
He's known worldwide and very passionate about his works, and he really wants to share his knowledge to everyone. Our guest speaker is Mr. Ahmad Fuadi. He is a novelist and also the founder of Komunitas Menara. He was also the director of communication for the Nature Conservancy and also a publication and information specialist at USAID LGSB. What makes him really amazing is the fact that he's a novelist, a journalist, and social entrepreneur. He specializes in writing, education, and communication. And he also wrote the best-selling novel, a trilogy called Negeri Lima Menara or The Land of Five Towers, and also Tanah Tiga Warna or The Earth of Three Colors. And he wrote other bunch of novels, which is really, really good. If you guys didn't know, Negeri Lima Menara was made into a movie in March 2012. I haven't seen the movie, but now that I know, I want to see it. He was born in Lake Maninjau in West Sumatra. He graduated from a university in Bandung called University of Pajajaran. He majored in international relations, and then he continued his study to United Kingdom and the United States. Can you imagine that? To study abroad? And what's really amazing is the fact that he was studying abroad by scholarship, so he was smart. He received prestigious scholarship called Schwinning Scholarship in London and the Fulbright Scholarship at George Washington University. So Negeri Five Menara was inspired by his birthplace. So the story starts off in the Lake Maninjau, West Sumatra. He was inspired by his mother, who owned a diary, and he started to hone his writing skill by writing up his own diary. It's good to have diary, guys, so you know what happened and you can just pour your feelings out. He admitted that he was not born with such skills. What made him a great talent is because he kept on practicing, trained his writing skills, and he kept on practicing to develop his skill. So guys, never say you can't do it, because you can. Well, by practicing, studying, you can't achieve anything.
Yeah, so he basically mentioned that his books are actually based on your life. So you never know, if you start writing now, maybe it would be a great turnout in the future, you know? If you really like writing, start writing now. Start honing your skills for writing,
and then you'll be good in the future.
So when he was younger, his mother forced him into going into an Islamic boarding school. He didn't really want to go, but he was forced into it, so he had no choice but to agree with it.
But what he doesn't know, that was actually a good option for him.
It was a good turnout for him. It was a future that he was never
expected.
He did a lot of jobs throughout his life. He worked as a journalist in Tempo magazine in 1998, and then
a TV editor and producer in VOA in 2001,
as well as a journalist and media specialist in VOA in the year of 2002,
and also a director of communication in the Nature of Conservancy on 2007.
And now,
a novelist,
he started his writing career in the year of 2007. It's amazing how his books have sent him abroad. He's been to five continents and 40 different countries,
such as Barcelona,
Paris, China, Frankfurt, Australia, London, and a lot more. So guys, writing could take you anywhere.
You could travel through the world.
And I think everyone wants to travel, right? I think the world is too big for us not to travel. And I love the idea that he believed in his books, and that he believed books can touch people's heart.
Because actually, what the writers are trying to do is trying to give emotion to the audience. So I think that's why he thinks books touches people's heart.
And it's amazing how his work are known worldwide, so he received offers from all over the world to share about his work. During his school days, he also mentioned that there was a phrase that became a big part in his life. It was manjada wajada, which means he who gives will surely succeed. So I think that's a really good phrase, and I think it could change anyone's perspective. Giving could be in any kind of form. It could be
sharing your knowledge with people.
It could be your wealth. It could be helping people, teaching people. It's anything. So once you receive something, once you get something, don't forget to give back to your community, to your people.
So you give and you receive. And with that in mind, in 2010, he initiated a non-profit foundation called the Comunitas Manara, which support unfortunate Indonesian children to access preschool education. So he actually
gave back to the society,
and he gave an opportunity for people who are
underprivileged,
who are unfortunate, to actually study.
And by the end of the seminar, he mentioned that he gave us several tips on how to write a great or a good novel.
He gave us 3 tips to be a good writer.
The first tip:
you should compromise of complex and dynamic characters. Characters whose personality evolve over the course of the story. So that what makes the story interesting.
You can't just not have like a very significant characters in the
story. You should know their background,
why they're doing that,
what they like,
what drives them like that,
why they dislike,
why
everything is important.
Should make sense.
The second tip:
you should include a journey, placing a struggle in the reality between the dream of the characters and what really is happening to them. So there should be a struggle, so that
like complex.
It would trigger people to just keep on reading.
It would spark the story even more.
What drives you, like, oh, I want to know
what's the end of this.
Yeah. So don't forget to include that if you want to write a good novel.
The third tip
is to write from our hearts. So because writing comes from within yourself. So if you love what you do, if you love what you write, then it would turn out
really
well, and it turns out naturally. You just have to believe in your writing, in your reality. And some people maybe disagree with you, but once you really pour your heart into something, everyone can see it.
It's a matter of fact of
how much effort you want to put in it.
That's basically it.
And I guess that's probably it for us guys this week.
I hope you like it
and enjoy it
and share it.
And then like it and comment it. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
And we'll see you guys next week.
Bye guys. Boy, you can be my sunshine. So fine, divine. In every way.